seen us, woken up, paying attention to us. Good. Wondering what happened to your team? Looks like they got moved to other floors. Interesting. Maybe that's why... Perhaps the casino recognized specific guests, or guests with a voice or look close enough for them to be assigned to that floor. We'll see. Had hoped with the power restored, the systems would fully awaken. Especially the sound archives. But no. Your teammates' callers on each floor are interfering with the systems. It's the white noise filters embedded in their construction. They're blocking the casino speakers, the music. You'll need to recalibrate or destroy each caller. To do that, you need to get close, reset the signal, to blow their heads off. I'll leave the choice up to you. My preference? End them now. They're of no use. After all, it's safe to kill them now, provided you make it quick. You see, the callers don't work inside the Sierra Madre. Well, between floors. Else I'd set off the callers. Be done with it. So find them, deal with them, as long as you're fast and can get off the floor after killing them. The floors, whatever they lined this place with, interferes with the caller frequency. So if you kill them, you should have some time to run. Oh, just not sure how long, may not be consistent. More or less, whatever. It doesn't matter. What we need is in the basement. We need to go to the top first and write our fortunes down. After we deal with your team on the other floors. I'll leave the choice up to you. My preference? End them now. They're of no use. After all, it's safe to kill them now, provided you make it quick. You see, the collars don't work inside the Sierra Madre. Well, between floors. Else I'd set off the collars. Be done with it. So find them, deal with them, as long as you're fast and can get off the floor after killing them. The floors, whatever they line this place with, interferes with the collar frequency. So if you kill them, you should have some time to run. Oh, just not sure how long, may not be consistent. More, less, whatever. It doesn't matter. What we need is in the basement. We need to go to the top first and write our fortunes down. After we deal with your team on the other floors.
To make Casino burn. No more being.
Hurry up and deal with the FEV reject. He's of no use to us.
Back in the cage. Stop what you're doing. We can... Can hear you now. Not much longer. Not listening to me. Tired of being your minder. Tired of... to protect you. The reason I have to take control is your master.
that idiot's opened the gas valves. A single spark, or he sets off his collar, the casino's going to burn. Us, along with him. Shut off the gas valves or that idiot will kill us all. Shut off the gas valves or that idiot will kill us all.
Cage, hungry, dog wants to protect you. Always wanted to protect you. The reason I have to take control is... Master sent me. Free. Dog needs to... Thank you. Always wants to protect you. Always wanted to protect you. The reason I have to take control is... Master. Master set me free. Dog needs to... die. Dog wants to die. Don't care. Tired of you. Tired of place. Help us. Please let me help us. If you don't, then... Always wanted to protect you. The reason I have to... Master. Master set me free. Dog needs to... Listen to me. If you do this, we both die. Dog wants to die. Don't care. Tired of you. All fire now. Burn away. No! Dog! Always wanted to protect you. All fire now. Burn away. No. Dog! always wanted to protect you. The reason I have to take control is...
Master. Master sent me.
Listen to me. If you do this, we both...
die. Og wants to die. Carol. Tired of you. Tired of place. Master.
Help us. Please let me help us. If you don't, then you're
to make Casino
back in the cage. Stop what you're doing. We can... Listening to me. Tired of being your minder. Tired
of putting dog to sleep. He wakes up. Cage. Dog
wants to protect you. Always wanted to protect you. The reason I have to take
Master said free. Dog needs to.
Listen to me. If you do this, we both.
Die.
Protect you. Always wanted to protect you. The reason I have to take control is...
Master. Master set me free. Dog.
Listen to me. If you do this, we both...
die. Dog wants to die.
Don't care. You? Master. No, not Master. Dog remembers you. Left dog in cage. Mean to dog. Now, dog. Will kill us both unless you do something. Never felt him so strong before. He won't listen to my voice. He's... hungry. Come here, or dog will chase you. Break you until you no run anymore. Master? Don't want Master to be mad. What does Master want dog to...
Listen to you. Can't hold him back much longer. Tell him to pull on his chain as hard as...
Dog can. What Master wants, dog can do. Please don't be mad with dog. Master? Master... Dog is listening.
Both of us are. Tell him to listen to me. Then we can get out of this. Finally. And...
Now dog is listening to voice. Your voice only. Dog can see the voice. Looks just like dog.
And dog looks just like me. You've hurt yourself. Inside. Do you see now? See?
In the water. Dog understands now. Dog knows what happened. If Dog...
He's right. If you merge us, then I... We... Or whatever we become... We can't help you when you reach whatever's at the Sierra Madre's end.
And Dog... Dog doesn't want to unremember you. May forget you.
We will forget almost all that has happened here. You'll be alone, at the old man's mercy. Like Dog. Like me.
Dog understands. Dog has done bad things. Knows why Voice was...
furious with him. Tired of the anger. Thank you, Courier. Even if it's only for minutes before the Sierra Madre kills us all, then...
Dog hopes you find a way to save Self, like you helped Dog. And...
when you meet him, find a way to save yourself, as you tried to save us. Otherwise, I'll be upset with you.
You were there all the time.
All the time. You were there. And so close. Together. Who are you? What is this place? That was not the answer I was expecting. I don't know you, yet I feel like I do, and a feeling of gratitude. Forgive me, I'm wounded. This chain, this bear trap on my arm. How did I even get this far with these wounds? The pain is excruciating. I need to rest for a moment. Thank you. For whatever you have done, I will remain here. Need to get my strength back.
thank you for whatever you have done.
I will remain here. Need to get my strength back.
Thank you.
For whatever you have done, I will remain here.
You've got one of the floors reestablished. Good. Accessing the music archives now. Two more to go. Oh, it seems the casino has uninvited guests. The villa inhabitants was pounding at the doors. Now they found a way inside. Deal with them, and don't try and leave yourself, or I'll let the caller do its work.
Still alive. Correct that. Or break him.
Finally, a friendly face. Hey, partner, up here. They're in a bit of a predicament here. Had to duck backstage, take a powder. The audience is a little murderous tonight. No idea. Woke up here, thought I was dreaming for a second. Right back on the stage, the mic. Thought I was back at the Fronds. Well, except no audience used to pack theaters back then. So, stepped up on the stage, checked things out. Then suddenly, holograms walked out of the wings. They started raising their hands to their heads, all creepy-like. Not a good sign. Look, those ghosts are going to come out of the wings behind you in a second. Security types, not the friendly, bald types. And if you got in here, the door's probably locked tight behind you, so don't back up or run for the exit. You're not going to make it. Trust me, as soon as you can, run to the door to the left. Use the key you got out of the music rag there and camp out. As bad as things are, it's going to get a lot worse if either of us pops. So get backstage.
Until we get a better plan.
Right, the locked door to the left. Watch out, the guards are going to materialize in any second. Crouch and take it slow. Yeah, yeah, so what? We got bigger problems with the holograms. No, wait. You're right. The theater piped music and sound backstage, which means those little squealers are in the corridors back there, too. Let's see. Once you break right, watch each turn in the corridor. One will be on your right, past my dressing room, and up. My dressing room. May have left the radio on, right by the table. If you could just shut it off instead of blowing it out. Never mind. And there was a speaker in the prop room, too, on the wall between the entrances. And, well, walk slow. There's bound to be more. The speakers are all controlled by a central console. It's the farthest from the only door out of here, so you'd need to do a full circuit of the corridor to get to it. Once there, you'll need to shut it down, and I don't have the code. If you have the code, you can turn off all the speakers, make them settle down. Getting backstage should buy us time. Just take it slow. Yeah, right. So, let's see. Security's here because the show hasn't started. Guests aren't allowed in, so guess we need to start the show. Okay, so when they were setting this place up, we had rehearsals. And Sinclair even set up hologram recordings of the shows so we could watch and critique our performances before a fake audience. Whatever. Thing is, when the recording queued up, a nice, calm, appreciative audience appeared in the theater. No security with their head-blasting zap rays. So, find the music, get it to the projector room upstairs, then play it. Might reset security with a shot. Right. Let's see. When you get the door open, there'll be an exit door dead ahead. Don't take it. It's most likely filled with toxins from the vents, so hug the wall. Make as much space between you and the door, or it's Cloud Nine in a casket. Past that is my dressing room. Under the table, there's a footlocker. It's tucked back a bit, so you might miss it. Inside, a gun, some ammo. Not much help against the ghosts. Still, if you're about to give up, call it quits. Throw it to me so I can eat a bullet first. You are preaching to the choir. Sinclair and his security, don't even get me started. Those holograms. Look, just get rid of them, all right? Tried to slip off stage, then they all started changing color and raising their hands. Not a good sign.
so, Tim. Pretty as a picture.
Hurry, would you? Get me out of this mess.
Thank you.
Oh, those electric ghosts aren't the kind of audience I like at the best of times. At least the ones in the villa had manners. Don't even know how I ended up here. Guess the casino still recognizes guests, even after all this time, huh? How's that for history? Yeah, now. Talk about a captive audience. Or captive entertainer. Whatever. Look, I'm more about the short goodbyes than long, thankful speeches. But I appreciate you bailing me out of a tight spot there, partner. I know you didn't do it out of the goodness of your heart. So let me give you something a little more practical. A way we both come out ahead. I'm not an idiot. I know the reason I'm in here now is because of the old guy. And you. And you're wearing a collar, so I trust you a little more than the old guy. He's more controlling than I'd like. Thing is, here's where being my partner pays off. See, I know how to get into the casino vault. There's a private elevator, Sinclair's elevator. It's up in the executive suites in Vera's room. Not a coincidence. Vera. She was my other partner before the bomb. Took some legwork. Some convincing made it happen. Sinclair was already puppy-eyed, so all I had to do was the introductions. She smiled, fluttered her eyes, showed a little leg, and he built this whole place for her. Made her the key to his vault, like a joke, cause of her name. Her fake Hollywood name. Except Sinclair didn't know I'd been there first. I could twist her whatever direction I wanted. All she had to do was get inside the Sierra Madre for the gala, then use her voice to open the door. After that, smooth sailing would have been the biggest heist in history. Sinclair left holding the bag, ruined. The bomb. Vera got sealed in here. A few hundred years go by, give or take. Almost the end of the story. Then you came along. Now we finish the job. Rob the Sierra Madre. Rip out its heart. Last chapter of Frederick Sinclair. Close the book. Problem? All high and mighty. Lording it over everyone. Acting so self-righteous, like nothing could touch him. He was the one with the problem. Never got mad at anything, nothing seemed to shake him. Even after his life kept getting dragged through the dirt. Always kept looking for the bright, shining future in everything. So, I decided to take everything from him. Do to me. What, weren't you listening? He thought he was better than me. Don't believe me? Look around. This big casino, this big colossal monument, think it was for some woman? No. All ego, all self-righteous and lights, fit him perfect. Had to take him down a few pegs, bring him down to my level. Begin again? Some things you don't get up from. I was going to prove it. I didn't know at first. Then the old man showed up. You showed up. Then that woman showed up, covered in scars. The one who makes all the hand signs, a little tight around the corners of her mouth. I put her in the clinic, tuned her like an instrument. If she heals up, it's not going to be her voice speaking anymore. That is, if the Sierra Madre didn't get her. If it did, well, there's enough of Vera around for me to spend a few years piecing a book together. Then she can make some beautiful music. I'm not banking on it. So here's the short of it. Piece together Little Miss Vera Keys' song in the right order. Sierra Madre opens its legs, we're in business. Go, knock yourself out. I'm just going to catch my breath a bit. That performance, well, more pressure than I was expecting. Not going to be performing here again, that's for sure. This place is a dump.
Another fragment. Good. Almost have the entirety of what I need from the music archives. Once you have the last fragment, you can thread the archive.
Find the mute and deal with her. She's somewhere on this floor. Floor's buzzing with emitter signatures. Watch out for holograms.
It's who I think it is. This is Christine. Recovered. In what looks like an old-world hotel room. High class. Two rooms. Exit sealed. All doors are locked down. Security's activated. And emitter signals are lighting up all over this floor. I'll do what I can from here. Floor's got holographic security. Not latest tech. Field of view targeting systems. Primitive. Familiar.
door to the vault is voice activated, which means we need the Starlet's voice or recordings of it.
Jumped over the lazy paladin. You made it. Good. There's to talk. I'll keep this quick in case my voice goes out. Do I? Sounds off to my ears. Hard to tell. Not to mention it hurts like hell to swallow. Might be why I got moved off to this suite. It's hers. That's her over there. Got trapped by security like I did. Just took a different way out. I've been hunting the one who hijacked your Pip-Boy, Elijah, for some time. He cannot leave the Sierra Madre alive. What he's done? What he's done here is nothing compared to what he's done in the past. The only way to bring him out is if you get to the vault. He won't allow you to go down there alone. That's when we kill him. Too long. Thought I might have had a chance to settle it before this event happened. But then the chance slipped away again. Wasn't sure until now I could trust you. Now I know. Look, when I woke up here, however that happened, I had this key on me. I think it belongs to her. Haven't had a chance to use it yet. Might open the dresser or the safe. Didn't have time to experiment with it before you arrived. Here you go. The gala went off. The switching station opened up. Thought the screeching in the auto dock was bad. Station worse. Got outside, saw the light show, and it was enough to make me run to the casino. Also, it seemed like the lights and speakers were helping to guide me. Guess your master wanted a backup in case you died. As for being assigned to this floor, maybe it's because of my new voice. Your guess is as good as mine. Maybe it recognized me as a guest. Try and reason with him, see what happens. He's so lost in his technology, I don't think he even understands why anymore. Yeah, still functional. A lot of garbage data on it. Its basic procedures should still work fine. I can see. Check the route. Recent diagnostics. A lot of Med-X was dispensed for Vera Keys. Guess that's her corpse there for certain. Why all those meds are scattered around in here. Here's the medical report. Looks like she had some sort of terminal condition. Diagnosis isn't conclusive. Must have been painful. I'm not even sure she knew if these medical reports are enough. She must have been numb most of the time. No. They run a lot deeper than that. While I was hunting Elijah in the Big Empty, he trapped me in one of those medical research centers buried there. It did something to my head, and I got off lucky. It's difficult enough to read now, and somehow the leap between what's in my head and words, it just ends up being a mishmash of symbols, not letters. Can still do math, formulas, equations. Writing poetry's out. Yeah, I saw records of other patients and what had been done to them. Some couldn't hear anything but static. Others just gibbering wrecks. Never going back. And Elijah was on his way here, so I couldn't stop to see if it was something I could fix. If you can even fix what happened to me when they jabbed the electrodes into my skull and turned my head into a flashlight. Then I got here, and my voice got severed. Now I have a new one. Another thing Elijah has to answer for. All right. Just glad I can answer you now. Good luck. He's not an easy opponent. If I can, I'll help. Might be able to figure something out using the Sierra Madre's computer systems. You're back. You sure you still want me here, callers and all? Not much for waiting around with a bomb around my neck.